welcome back to another Tech Minds video. So if, like me, you spend some time scanning around the frequencies using your SDR radio and SDR software, and you come across a signal that you're not familiar with, well, what do you do? Now, this signal could be anything. It could be voice, CW, or even a data mode. But how do you normally go about finding what this transmission is? Now, for me, I would normally just type that frequency into Google and see what comes up, and then spend some time trying to decipher what it is by doing research. Now, another solution, and most likely the quickest, would be to use the CLOUDMARKERS plugin within SDRuno. Now, if you're not an SDRuno user, then I'll definitely recommend installing it, as it's a free download and also works with RTL SDR devices, not just SDR Play. Of course, using with an original SDR device would be preferable. So how does CLOUDMARKERS plugin work? So first off, let's take a look at this frequency shown on the screen at 3.854 MHz. Now, I already know what this is, but if you didn't, then you just need to load the CLOUDMARKERS plugin like this. Go to the plugin section, select CLOUDMARKERS, and then click load plugin. And once loaded and shown on the screen as a pop-up, you'll be presented with a list of possible transmissions near where your VFO is set. As well as the list in the pop-up, you'll also see a marker displayed on the FFT. Now, by clicking once on this entry, you'll be able to read any description text that has been entered by the person that created this marker. In the list, it should show the frequency, a name of the transmission, the mode of modulation, the country, and any flags. So for this transmission, this is a WeFax transmission, which contains weather information as an image or a fax. Now, using WeFax decoding software, which you can download separately, you can then start to decode the transmission. So the hardest part of all this without the CLOUDMARKERS plugin would have been finding out what that transmission was. Now, you may have noticed there was a CW transmission just a little higher up in frequency. So if we move the VFO closer to this, the list in the CLOUDMARKERS plugin screen updates. As you can see here, someone has flagged this before with some possible useful information. Here they state it's coded 5-letter words, and in the description, it says possibly military coded CW. So let's take a moment to look at this screen, and to get to this screen, I had a frequency selected and then clicked edit. Now, if you knew more information about this marker, then you could also enter your own text for others to see. The CLOUDMARKERS plugin also works locally if required. And at the bottom of the edit page, you can choose whether to share this marker with the cloud database and all others, or you can save this marker locally for personal use. Now, personally, I think if you have vital information about a specific marker, then I'd recommend to share it with the cloud so that all other users can benefit from this information. Now, one feature I'm not sure about is whether or not the plugin automatically syncs with the cloud data. So to make sure I have the latest information available, I click the sync button on the main plugin screen. When you click it, you'll see that it does a very quick download. So obviously you will need to be connected to the internet for that to work. Now, as mentioned before, when you start changing the VFO frequency, the CLOUDMARKERS plugin screen will update and show you nearby transmissions that have previously been detected and logged. It's not just obscure transmissions either. You will find the ham radio amateur bands with popular digital modes and voice modes, and you'll also find broadcast radio stations listed. This is particularly useful if you're a Crane Broadcast DXer, because when the conditions become favourable, you may hear a radio station from another country and not know what it is, especially if it's in a different language. But if someone has already logged this in CLOUDMARKERS, then hopefully you'll have that information instantly. Another example I can show you is this signal here, all around 11.84 MHz. These short packets of data would be quite hard to track down, but by using the plugin data, we can see that this is actually HFDL, which is an ACAR system for aircraft on the HF band. Using the appropriate third-party software, we can then easily decode these short bursts of data transmissions. Now, the CLOUDMARKERS plugin has its own dedicated website, which can be found at markers.cloud. Even though SDRuno comes with a community plugin package and is installed automatically, it may be worth checking the website periodically for any updates. You can then download the new version from the website and install onto your computer. What's also nice about this plugin is that it's open source. So if you're interested to see how it works or want to add some improvements, then you can access the source code via GitHub, which is linked from the markers.cloud website. Well, there we go, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video and I hope you learned something new about this plugin for SDRuno. I definitely use it quite often now, and also I do contribute to it as well when I find some transmissions that I know exactly what they are, but they're not already in the database. Until the next video, stay safe, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.